From Amateur Radio Newsline Report, number 2224, these are the Ham Nation headlines for Wednesday, June 17th, 2020. Our top story this week comes from The Sun, or rather it comes from Newsline science editor Dr. Tamitha Scove, WX6SWW, who has some encouraging news about the next solar cycle.
After nearly a decade of waiting for astronaut launches to return to American soil, SpaceX successfully launched astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley into orbit on the 30th of May, 2020. The flight, which lasted 19 hours in the newly christened Dragon Ship Endeavour before it docked with the International Space Station, has quickly become known as the moment we ushered in a new era of human spaceflight. Not since 1969 have we seen a rocket launch this anticipated. But the astronauts were not the only ones making history. Just a day prior, our sun decided it was time to wake up from its long slumber and remind humanity to always check the weather before flying. The space weather, that is. With almost no warning, it launched the first two big solar flares of the new solar cycle on May 29th, 2020, less than one day before the launch. Welcome to Solar Cycle 25. Luckily for the astronauts, the sun's solar flare radio bursts only lasted for a few hours. And then, as if in anticipation, the sun quieted down for the final countdown. The rest, as they say, is history. Of course, most will remember this week as the moment we returned the power of human spaceflight to American soil. But amateur radio operators, with a nod and a wink, will always know that our sun celebrated right along with us in its own unique way. This is Tamitha Scove, WX6SWW, for Amateur Radio Newsline.
We have news of one more amateur radio casualty of the pandemic, this time in France.
The organizers of Ham Expo 2020 in France have called off the major amateur radio event in Le Mans. The French National Amateur Radio Society said the COVID-19 pandemic has made it unwise to proceed on schedule with the October 10th event. Instead, planning has already begun for next year's event at the Le Mans Exhibition Centre, which will take place on the 25th of September 2021. The president of the Association of French Transmitters Network, Jean-Louis Trouquet, F5DJL, said in the translation of a public posting, "We hope that you will understand this difficult decision, which is in keeping with our desire to protect the health of our community and yours." From Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Ed Durant, DD5LP.
In one U.S. city, the challenge of keeping life orderly during troubled times has been amplified and complicated for police because of one issue that is well known to radio amateurs: jamming.
Jamming is perhaps one of the most adversarial forces out there for ham radio operators. Now, one Midwestern city's police department is afflicted with the same problem. In the middle of the kind of explosive riots, looting, and protests that are rocking many of the cities around the United States, as Chicago police officers struggled to respond to dispatchers' emergency radio calls within the troubled city, jammers were filling the frequencies with music and slogans that interrupted communications, according to a report in the Chicago Sun-Times newspaper. Dan Casey, Deputy Director of Public Safety Information Technology in the Office of Emergency Management and Communications, said that although some police frequencies are encrypted, most officers' radios aren't protected from hacking. Although the move in cities across the U.S. is to employ more secure digital radio systems, Casey told the newspaper that local and federal authorities were being given recordings of the transmissions. Jamming is illegal, and an accused jammer can face a substantial prison term if convicted. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Kent Peterson, KC0DGY.
And that's all from the Amateur Radio Newsline, your independent source for amateur radio news for four decades and counting at arnewsline.org. With Tamitha Scove, WX6SWW, Ed Durant, DD5LP, Kent Peterson, KC0DGY, Karen Eve Murray, KD2GUT at the news desk in New York, and our news team across the globe. I'm Don Wellbanks, AE5DW73. We'll see you next time here on Ham Nation.